I propose to increase the period of holding in respect of such units from 12 months to 36 months for this purpose. In the year 2003, a tax liability on income by way of dividend was shifted from the shareholder to the company. The shareholder was required to pay tax on gross dividends, but now the company pays tax on dividend amount net of taxes. Similarly, in the case of mutual fund, income distribution tax is paid on the income distributed net of taxes. I propose to remove this anomaly both in the case of the company and the mutual fund. Currently, where the SSE fails to deposit, deduct and pay tax on specified payments to residents, 100% of such payments are not allowed as deduction while computing these income. This has caused undue hardship to taxpayers, particularly where the rate of tax is only 1 to 10%. I propose to provide that instead of 100%, only 30% of such payments will be disallowed. The Direct Tax Code 2010 has lapsed with the dissolution of the 15th Lok Sabha. Having considered the report of the Standing Committee and the views expressed by the stakeholders, my predecessor had praised a revised code in public domain in 2014. The government shall consider all comments received from stakeholders on the revised code. The government will also review the DTC in its present take and take a view in the whole matter. Income Tax Department is expected to function not only as an enforcement agency but also as a facilitator. A number of Aayakar Seva Kendra have been opened in different parts of the country. I propose to extend this facility by opening 60 more such Seva Kendras along with the current financial year to promote excellence in service delivery. The focus of any tax administration is to broaden the tax base. Our policy thrust is to adopt a non-intrusive method to achieve this object. In this direction, I propose to make a greater use of information technology techniques. The net effect of the direct tax proposals is a revenue loss of rupees 22,200 crores. Indirect taxes. I now turn to indirect taxes and shall begin with custom duties. Manufacturing sector is under a stress due to the variety of reasons. To boost the domestic manufacturing sector and also to address the issue of inverted duties, I propose to reduce the basic customs duty on fatty acid, crude palm stearin RBD and other palm stearins, specified industrial grade crude oils, from 7.5% to nil for manufacture of soaps and oleochemicals. Crude glycerin from 12.5% to 7.5%, and crude glycerin used in manufacture of soaps from 12.5% to nil. Steel grade limestone and steel grade dolomite from 5% to 2.5%. Battery waste and battery scrap from 10% to 5%. Coal tar pitch from 10% to 5%. Specified inputs for manufacture of spandex yarn from 5% to nil. In order to encourage new investment and capacity additions in chemicals and petrochemical sectors, I propose to reduce basic custom duty on reformate from 10% to 2.5% on ethane, propane, ethylene, propylene, butadiene and orthoxylene from 5% to 2.5% on methyl alcohol and denatured ethyl alcohol from 7.5% to 5% and in crude naphthalene from 10% to 5%. The demand of the electronics is growing very fast. To boost domestic production and reduce our dependence on imports, I intend to take the following steps. Impose basic custom duty of 10% on specified telecommunication products that are outside the purview of the information technology agreement. Exempt all inputs, components used in the manufacture of personal computers from 4% special additional duty. Impose educational cess on imported electronic products to provide parity between domestically produced goods and imported goods. Exempt 4% SAD on PVC and ribbon used for manufacture of smart cards. Cathode rays TVs are used by the weaker sections who cannot afford to buy more expensive flat panel TVs. I propose to exempt color picture tubes from basic custom duty to make cathode rays TVs cheaper. The duty concession will help to revive the manufacturing of the TVs in the SME sector and create employment opportunity. At the same time, to encourage production of LCDs, LEDs and TVs below 19 inches in India, I propose to reduce the basic custom duty on LCD LED panels below 19 inches and 10% to nil. Further, to encourage manufacture of LCDs, LED panels, I propose to exempt them from basic custom duty specified inputs in their manufacture. The domestic stainless steel industry is presently suffering from severe underutilization of capacity. To give an impetus to stainless steel industry, I propose to increase the basic customs duty on imported flat roll products of stainless steel from 5% to 7.5%. We need to maximize our utilization of solar power. The existing duty structure incentivizes imports rather than domestic manufacturing on solar photovoltaic cells and modules. Therefore, I propose to exempt from basic custom duty specified inputs to use in the manufacture of EVA sheets and black sheets, flat copper wires and manufacture of PV ribbons. A concessional basic custom duty of 5% is also being extended to machinery equipment required for setting up of project for solar energy production. To promote wind energy, I propose to reduce basic custom duty from 10% to 5% on forged steel rings used in manufacturing bearings of wind-operated electricity generators. Also, I propose to exempt the SAD of 4% on parts of raw materials required for manufacture of wind-operated generators. Further, I propose to prescribe a concessional basic custom duty of 5% on machinery and equipment required for setting up of compressed biogas plants. I have only highlighted some of the proposals in budget 2014-15. I am sure these measures would incentivize value, generate income and create more jobs. I have also undertaken several tax rationalization measures. At present, coal attracts a custom duty at different rates. I propose to rationalize these duty structures on all non-agglomerated coal at 2.5% of basic custom duty and 2% CVD. Henceforth, anthracite coal, bituminous coal, coking coal, steam coal and other coal will attract the same duty. This will eliminate all assessment disputes and transactional costs associated with testing of various parameters of coal. Metallurgical coke is manufactured out of coking coal. The basic custom duty on metallurgical coke is being increased from nil to 2.5% in line with the duty of coking coal. Ships imported for breaking up attract basic custom duty at 5%. As against this, melting scrap of iron or steel attracts a basic custom duty of 2.5%. I propose to rationalize the duty on ship breaking scrap and melting scrap of iron and steel by reducing the basic custom duty on ship imported for breaking up from 5% to 2.5%. Semi-processed, half-cut or broken diamonds are at present exempted from basic custom duty. As against this, cut and polished diamonds and colored gemstones attract basic custom duty of 2%. To prevent misuse and avoid assessment disputes, the basic custom duty on semi-processed, half-cut, broken diamonds, cut and polished diamonds and colored gemstones is being rationalized at 2.5%. To encourage exports, preforms of precious or semi-precious stones are being fully exempted from basic custom duty. To encourage exports of ready-made garments, I propose to increase the base duty-free entitlement of import of trimmings, embellishments and other items from 3% to 5% of their value of their exports. Considering the need to conserve our natural resources, I propose to increase the export duty on bauxite from 10% to 20%. The free baggage allowance under baggage rules, which was last revised in 2012, as a measure of passenger facilitation, I propose to increase the baggage fare from ₹35,000 to ₹45,000. I shall now deal with the excise duties. To provide the fillip to capital goods, consumable durables and automatic sectors and give our commitment to revive economic growth, I have already extended the excise duty concessions beyond 30th June 2014 for a period of 6 months up to 31st December 2014. We expect the industry to show positive results in the coming months. In continuation of this, I have made more proposals to boost domestic production. Minimization of harvest and poor harvest losses of agricultural produces is an important measure for tackling food inflation and ensuring food security. The losses of fruits, vegetables are mainly due to adequate processing capacity. To incentivize expansion of processing capacity, I propose to reduce the excise duty on specified food processing and packaging machinery from 10% to 6%. As a measure of relief to the footwear industry, most of which are SMEs, I propose to reduce excise duties from 12% to 6% on footwear of retail piece exceeding 500 pairs, but not exceeding rupees 500 per pair, but not exceeding rupees 1,000 per pair.